So let's start with unit number 5. It is about the basics of electronic engine control. Coming to the introduction of this, the initial motivation for electronic engine control came in part from two government requirements. The first requirement is about So the first came about as the result of legislation to regulate automobile exhaust emissions under the authority of the Environmental Protection Agency. As there are a lot of norms which automobile industry has to follow regarding the exhaust emission from the automobiles. So for that purpose, electronic engine control is of really important to have a control over the exhaust gases. The second was a thrust to improve the national average fuel economy by the government regulation, as every individual is concerned about the fuel economy or the mileage produced by the automobile. Similarly, government also put a norm that how we can improve the national average fuel economy. So for that purpose also, electronic engine control unit is a very important part in every automobile. The issue involved in these regulations, along with the normal market forces, continue to motivate improvements in reduction of regulated gases as well as fuel economy. So apart from these, this government regulation, there are a lot many competitiveness in the market, which put forces on the different automobile companies so as to do a regulation over the gases and the fuel economy. Electronic engine control is only one of the automotive design factor involved in fuel economy improvement. Now coming to the concept of an electronic engine control system. In order to understand electronic engine control, it is necessary to understand some fundamentals of how the power produced by the engine is controlled. So basically in this unit, we will consider that what are the fundamentals of electronic engine control system and how the power produced by the engine is controlled electronically through that system. Any driver understands that the throttle, that means acceleration, directly regulates the power produced by the engine at operating condition. It does this by controlling the airflow into the engine, as we have inlet manifold through which airflow can be controlled. But now in this unit, we will understand how it can be controlled electronically. In essence, the engine is an air pump such that at any RPM, the mass flow air rate of air into the engine varies directly with throttle plate angular position. So in the earlier unit, we have studied that how the throttle plate angular position sensor gives us the input, and based upon those input, the engine electronic control system brings a variation in the mass airflow rate as per the requirement of RPM. As the driver depresses the accelerator paddle, the throttle angle increases, which increases the cross-sectional area through which the air flows. This reduces the resistance to airflow and thereby allowing an increased airflow into the engine. So this way we have connected an accelerator paddle, and accelerator paddle brings a change in the throttle angle, and through that throttle angle change, there is a sensor which gives command to the engine electronic control, and through that engine electronic control, the manifold air pressure can be changed. The role of fuel control is to regulate the fuel that is mixed with the air so that it increases in proportion to the airflow. So whenever there is a change in airflow, it is required that the fuel which is going to be mixed with the air should also proportionately increase, so that the stoichiometric coefficient can be maintained as required. So the performance of the engine is affected strongly by the mixture, that is by the ratio of air to fuel. However, for any given mixture, the power produced by the engine is directly proportional to the mass flow rate of air into the engine. In the US system of units, as a rough rule of thumb, an air flow rate of around 6 pounds per hour produces 1 horsepower of usable mechanical power at output of the engine. But this analysis is done on the some ideal conditions. There can be some changes also. Metric units have come to be more commonly used, in which engine power is given in kilowatts and air mass is given in kilogram. So here is one formula given for that. Power is given by PB, which is equals to K into MA, where K is the constant relating the power to airflow and MA is the mass airflow rate. Of course, it is assumed that all parts of the engine, including ignition timing, are functioning correctly for this relationship to be valid. So in the upcoming lecture, we will continue further about the electronic engine control system.